memorizing sequence in details, how to make their connections, creating relationships between the information we are reading and our background knowledge, for example. I will look at in more details for looking at the reading comprehension skills at primary schools in general. Normally, students at primary schools look at non-fiction and fiction text. This is a fiction. What is a fiction and what is a non-fiction? Fiction make up story. The story and the non-fiction, that's the real information text that the student read to learn the information. So normally we can divide all the text into these two. Look back to the skills we need to deal with when we read fiction reading. And we have to decode from the bottom up and also from the top down. We read the words, phrases to create the meaning of the story. And then we look at the plot, we look at the setting, we look at the sequence of all the events in the reading, and we think about the characters, we think how do they use the words, how to make the dialogues in reading. And more importantly, we come to the reading to make the connections between what we are reading and our own experience. So we have to the connection between or in another word, we can call it text-to-self connection. Text-to-self. So connect to our own experience. What's the difference or the same? Have you ever been in that situation before? So we need to create that connection when we're reading. Or another one, when we read, we need to create the mental image. But when we read the sentence, what's the picture in our mind about that? How can we think about that? So that's some of the skills underneath the reading that we need to explore and focus when we are teaching. Well, together with that, we have book-to-book connections. So not only making the connections between what we're reading and our own experience, we also need to create the connections between what we're reading, this book and another book, and also make the connection between what we are reading and the issues in the world outside, in larger context, that one. And then comparing and contrasting, that's some of the skills for fiction reading that I have discovered while we are teaching in the literature. For non-fiction reading, we come up with a series of sub-skills that we need to deal with. So because non-fiction, we are learning the knowledge, you know, we are pick up the knowledge while we're reading, so we will deal with the connections between our what we know about the topic and what we are reading. What do you want to learn more about that to motivate the students to read more about the topics in order to deal with that? And then we need to analyze the organization of the information, opinion, and reason for this one. We learn how to ask questions, to raise questions, to ask questions, how to read the pictures in the non-fiction materials, how to read the captions and labels, things and things, how to create the new information for the most interesting part of that one. So that all the, or in another word, for teaching reading nowadays, we learn how to read what the student thinks, and we teach a student how to track their thinking while you're reading. And it's not just limited to read and answer the questions. So it's things. That's one. So now, have a look at this. Oh. So we come up with find meaning in the text and think deeply what we are reading. So that all the skills that a student needs to build to be the strong readers in the 21st century. So I look at what can be called the strong readers in the for the 21st century. So the student needs to explicit instructions in vocabulary development that you have learned from Dr. Kane, that one. So I just want to emphasize on this one. For teaching vocabulary, we need to teach both words and concepts about the words. So together with the words, we learn all the things, the concepts underneath that vocabulary. So after that, the students have a sense of that vocabulary and that what they are using, that one. And in order to do that, we need to connect the words to the experience. And one more time, I just want to emphasize on the connection. We need to create the connects while we are reading. And for the 21st century skills, we focus on 4 C's, as you can see here. That 4 C for that one. So the student needs to read in order to develop the knowledge and skills that they need for their life. And also, they need to create the connections, and we focus on thinking and creativity. For this study, in order to answer these 2 research questions to explore what's happening at school when the student learn reading, so I had an interview. I had interviews with 10 teachers at primary schools in the north of Vietnam. I did some observations where they are teaching, and look at the textbooks that they are teaching, teachers' books that they use, in order to see what's going on. And I can come up with some of the patterns that we can see very clearly why we talk to them. First of all, the teacher used text-dependent questions too much. So this can be text-dependent questions can be the main method to check comprehension. But in the literature, as we can see that, we need to ask if it's enough or not to check the student understanding with text-dependent questions, with multiple choice questions and short answers for that one, or the read-to-make questions in textbooks. So they read the book, that they read the text, and then they answer the questions. If the student get their correct answers, and the teachers think that, oh, they understand the text. But gradually, it will come up with the habits that we read in order to answer the questions in the textbooks, not to read in order to explore the things, to create the connections underneath of that. So the activities they used, read and answer the questions, read and complete sentences, read and choose the correct answers. Normally, that's some of the repeating activities happening in the reading sections. And they focus on how to explore the vocabulary in the reading, analyze the sentence structures, and they also focus on reading skills. What reading skills do they focus on? They focus on specific information or the stated information in that one. By answering their questions in the textbooks, and then they focus on general information. Now, let's have a look at these patterns back to the literatures. And now, I just want, but back to the skills that we need in order to raise the strong readers for the 21st century. What will happen? We have this one. If we just ask the student to answer the questions, what level of thinking do you think that the students would deal up with? Remember.
Understanding
a little bit. Yeah. But if you just focus on questions and answers, a series of questions and answers about specific information right after reading the textbooks, we cannot help the student move up to the higher thinking order, especially the hardest one for creating. You can't move them up there because they will have the habits of answering the questions right after the reading. And why do they need to read the text? Because the teachers asked me to answer the questions. And right after the question, oh, done. Stop there without thinking, without creating any kind of connections between what they are reading and what they really need in order to be strong as an adult. Now, look back to this one. Look back. Do the tasks with questions and answers help them to develop critical thinking? Expect, maybe no. Because all the questions there, if we, normally that's the stated information questions. Yeah. So the student just, keywords. Look up to the text, keywords. Read that text and fill it out. Even without understanding what's the sentence about. Communications. No. Thank you. and collaboration. No, reading. Some teachers say reading is boring. Because it's, we need to ask the student read and then answer the questions. No, collaborations. And the most important thing, one of the most important skills for the 21st century is creativity. That will be a little bit ignored in the set of the questions and answers series. Now, look back to the little bit motivations. When we need to build up the intrinsic motivations for the students, what kind of questions and answers series will help them? Do they create the challenge for them? Do they create the choice? What the student doing? Imagination? No. Well, so from the findings, from the literatures, and from the connection between what we are doing and what we need in order to create the heart, the strong readers for the 21st century, I just come up with the argument for this one. So text-dependent questions, if we just limit all the activities to the text-dependent questions, is not enough. And it build up all the information with questions and answers, questions and answers. So we need to move the reading activity a little beyond it. How can we do that? So we need to practice life skills, integrate the knowledge for 21st centuries where the student learn how to read and how to analyze the text. And we focus on deep thinking with creating the connections between what they are reading, visualizing what they are reading, and do the activities after that by making that connections. Right, so what I will show you. For this slide, I just want to focus on what I'm using now is I'm using a lot about graphic organizers and interactive notes in order to check the comprehension skills instead of using questions and answers, and I will show you some of the learning evidences that the students have created to support their creativity and productivity while they are reading instead of just asking for giving the questions and answers, giving the answers to the question. So this one, no questions, no answers, but they are creating the connections. They are exploring the meaning of the words by relating it to their experience. Night out or conference, what does it mean to you? Conference, happy, a lot of people, lecturers, listening, meeting friends. So underneath one word, we have a whole range of concepts relating to that. All right, the same for that one. We use the story map to analyze the characters, sequence, problems, and solutions for that one. And we use some notes to analyze the text. We create the mental image when we're reading. This one, it's some of the... It's something more than questions and answers right after the text, and it's one of the arguments I would like to raise during this conference in order to do further research on that. I will show you some. That's not questions and answers, but they can create something. They can do something with that. Beautiful. And we can create the connections between what you're reading, and then they can talk about it. And they have the they will have the motivation to learn more about it and do the same thing because they are motivated to do that. So now come up with further study. If anyone would like to explore or to do or experience this kind of teaching and learning, and we can do further research with this one, and I come up with these research questions, and maybe I'll do this year and present it next year. And I would like to conclude my presentations with the three principles for the mind to flourish by Sir Ken Robinson, that we need curiosity, we need diversity while we're reading, and we need to help the student build up their creativity. Thank you very much for watching.